Dear learners, I am Siba. In this session, we are going to study business support services. In that, we are going deep into postal and telecom services and insurance. Postal and telecom services include parcel post, courier, and saving services. Parcels of specified size and weight can be sent through postal department or through post. Postal charges for parcels vary according to the weight of the parcel or according to the distance. Using parcel post, articles are sent across the country and outside the country. We have courier services, which are offered by private sector enterprises. Letters, products in small quantity are sent from one place to another with the help of courier service. And postal saving services include recurring deposit in post office, national savings certificate, public provident fund, and monthly income schemes. Recurring deposit that is provided by the post office. In this scheme, a certain amount of money is deposited every month for specified time period. For example, every month money is deposited for 5 years or for 10 years. In RD or recurring deposit scheme, total amount plus interest will be repaid on maturity. Passbook is given to the account holder. Check facility is not given. Amount is payable on maturity in the case of recurring deposit scheme provided by post office. Another savings scheme provided by the post office, National Savings Certificate. NSC is taken for any amount of rupees 100 and more. The term is for 5 years or for 10 years. That is, NSC is taken for 5 years or for 10 years. Total amount plus interest will be repaid on maturity. When you are investing in NSC, tax benefit is available up to rupees 1 lakh. You can invest or tax benefit up to rupees 1 lakh can be availed through NSC. Another savings scheme provided by the Postal Department, Public Provident Fund. Any adult can open a PPF account by depositing every year an amount in between rupees 500 and rupees 1 lakh in some specified banks or in a post office. PPF term is 15 years. It can be extended for further 15 years. Passbook facility is given to the account holder in PPF. Tax benefit is there for PPF under 80C of the Income Tax Act of 1961. Another scheme of the post office, monthly income scheme. An Indian can open a monthly income scheme in single name or jointly with another person. Deposit is made one time in monthly income scheme up to rupees 4.5 lakh if it is operated by one person or in the name of one person's account. And deposit is made one time up to rupees 9 lakh if it is a joint account. Interest is paid monthly in MIS scheme. Deposit amount paid to the account holder at the end of 5 years in MIS. Passbook facility is given to the account holder and premature withdrawals is not allowed in monthly income scheme. Next, coming to insurance. Insurance provides protection against losses from such risk of the business for a nominal charge called premium. Insurance helps the business in recovering the losses which may arise due to various happenings in the course of business. And losses will be covered partly or fully from the insurance company. The term insurance refers to a contract between two parties. One person is the insured and the other party is the insurer. Here, insurer, in exchange of a fixed sum of money, agrees to compensate the insured against risk of loss or damage caused by happening of certain events. Document containing the contract is known as insurance policy. The person whose risk is insured is the insured or assured. The company which insures or company which will provide money to the insured is the insurer or assurer. The consideration in return for which the insurer agrees to compensate the insured, that is, the insurance company will agree to compensate any person or company for the premium paid by the particular person or company, that is the consideration, premium paid by the company or the insurer. Coming to the importance of insurance. Insurance provides protection against risk, any type of risk, like natural risk or other type of risk. Sharing of risk is possible with the help of insurance. That is, fund is created by pooling the premium of so many insurance holders, and if any loss is coming to any person, insurance company will utilize this fund to cover the loss. So, it is a kind of sharing of risk. Insurance helps in securing loans. In the case of houses or any other fixed assets, nowadays banks are demanding insurance for such property or any commodity for getting loan. That is, first insurance should be taken for that particular item and then only loan will be provided by the concerned banks. So, insurance helps in securing loans. If any loss is occurring to any employee, either any death or severe damage to any employee, then insurance comes here for the protection against any such liabilities under various labor laws. And insurance contribute to economic development. The fund of various persons are collected in the form of premium by the insurance company, and this fund is utilized for the growth or invested in some other projects so that economic development of the country is possible. And many insurance agents are working throughout the country. So, insurance is helping in generating employment opportunity inside our country. We have different types of insurance like life insurance, fire insurance, marine insurance and other types of insurance. Life insurance is a contract whereby the insurer undertakes to pay a certain sum of money either on the death of the insured or on the expiry of a specified period of time, in consideration of certain amount, that is premium, paid by the insured either in lump sum or in installment. Here we have life insurance. You must have heard this word. During your life and after your life, here comes the help of life insurance. If you are taking life insurance, that will come to your protection during your life and after your life. The risk insured is certain to happen and the sum assured is bound to be paid sooner or later in the case of life insurance. That is, we are sure that death of a person will occur, so it is certain to happen. And the sum that is assured should be paid very sooner or later. So that is the feature of life insurance. Types of life insurance includes whole life policy and endowment policy. In the case of whole life policy, the premium is payable regularly throughout the life of the insured or for a fixed period. The sum assured becomes payable to the heirs of the insured after his death. Nominee will be given the amount only after the death of the concerned person in the case of whole life policy. Policy is taken for the whole life. Policy taken to provide support to the dependent after the death of the concerned person. So that is about whole life policy. Coming to endowment policy. An endowment policy is running for a limited period or up to a certain age of the insured. And the sum assured becomes due for the payment at the end of the specified period. So sum is payable after a certain period or on the death of the insured. Whichever is coming earlier, that is the specified period or the death of the insured, whichever is coming earlier, at that point of time, insurer or insurance company will pay the amount to the concerned person or to the legal heirs. Other types of policy, joint life policy, money back policy, pension plan, unit plan and group insurance scheme. First, joint life policy. Under this policy, life of two or more persons are insured jointly. The sum assured becomes payable on the death of anyone. To the survivor, the sum assured is payable. So we are jointly insuring, and the death of any one person occurs, then the sum assured should be payable to the survivor. Usually joint life policy is taken by the husband and wife or by partners. Another type of insurance policy, money back policy. This scheme provides periodic payment to the policy holder. For example, in case of a 20-year money back policy, 20% of the sum assured becomes payable after 5 years, 10 years, 15 years. That is, if you are taking 1 lakh rupees, 20% of that 20,000 will be payable to the policy holder after 5 years. Then again after 10 years, 20,000, and 15 years, at the end of 15 year, again 20,000, and the balance 40% plus the bonus becomes payable at the 20th year. Next is pension plan. Under this plan, the sum assured is payable to the policy holder on his survival beyond the term of the policy. The sum assured or policy money becomes payable in monthly installments or quarterly installments or half yearly installments. Pension plan provides regular income after certain age. Next is the unit plan. Here, if you are taking unit plan, it will provide twin benefit like investment and insurance cover. Premium paid by the policy holder in unit plan is used to purchase shares of different companies. And maturity amount in unit plan depends on the market value of investment. Why? Because we are using this amount invested in unit plan to purchase shares. So if it is invested in shares, means the return value will depend on the market value of the investment. Next scheme, group insurance scheme. Life insurance at low cost is provided to a group of people with the help of group insurance scheme. Group insurance scheme is suitable to employees group of any office. So we have studied life insurance. Now coming to fire insurance. It is a contract whereby the insurer, in consideration of premium, undertakes to compensate the insured for the loss or damage suffered due to fire. Premium is paid in single installment in the case of fire insurance. That is, you are paying only one installment in the case of fire insurance. Fire insurance is taken for 1 year. Automatically, this insurance will come to an end after 1 year. Fire insurance conditions are there, that is, actual fire should be there. Fire should be accidental and it should not be intentional. That is, some of the persons or organizations will make fire because only one time we are paying the installment. And if there is no loss, means we will not get any money back from the insurance company, from the fire insurance. So it is a condition that the actual fire should be there. We should not put the particular organization in fire and claim for the insurance coverage that has arisen because of fire. So condition, it's fire should be accidental. It should not be intentional. Purposefully, you should not create fire and claim for the insurance. Fire insurance is a contract of indemnity. The insured cannot claim anything more than the value of property lost or damaged by fire, or the amount of the policy, whichever is lower. Coming to marine insurance. It is an agreement by which the insurance company agrees to indemnify the owner of a ship or cargo against risks which are incidental to marine adventures. So, which are the risks that are covering because of marine happenings? That will be covered in the case of marine insurance. Categories of loss in marine insurance include loss to the ship, loss to the cargo or freight. Marine insurance include cargo insurance, ship insurance or hull insurance, freight insurance. Marine insurance that covers the risk of loss of cargo is known as cargo insurance. That is, the goods that are transmitted may be lost in transit. The loss of the commodities or goods that are inside the ship will be covered in the case of cargo insurance. Coming to hull insurance. When the owner of a ship is insured against loss on account of perils of the sea, damage of the sea that can occur to the ship. So that is the ship insurance or hull insurance. Any damage that has occurred to the ship because of the sea, that will be covered in hull insurance. Freight insurance, freight is payable by the owner of the cargo on its safe delivery at the port of destination. The shipping company may seek insurance of the risk of loss of freight. Such a marine insurance is known as freight insurance. Other types of insurance include motor vehicles insurance, health insurance. Motor vehicles insurance are given for the loss that is happening due to accidents or loss by theft. Insurance coverage is given for such happenings to that particular motor vehicle which is insured. For the health charges, insurance is taken by some persons, that is health insurance, to cover the loss that is occurring due to health charges. We are taking health insurance. Other types of insurance include crop insurance. Loss may occur to crop due to crop failures due to flood, drought, etc. And insurance is taken to cover such losses. Cash insurance is taken to cover the loss of money in transit. Cattle insurance is taken to cover the loss due to death of cow, buffalo, etc. We have different principles of insurance. Principle of utmost good faith, insurable interest, indemnity, contribution, subrogation and mitigation. First principle of utmost good faith. Both the parties of the contract, that is the insurer and the insured, insurance company and the person who is taking the insurance, must disclose all important facts, relevant information relating to the subject matter of insurance. In the case of life insurance, the proposer or the insured must honestly disclose all information relating to the health, habits, personal history, family history, etc. of that particular person before taking life insurance. Here, concealment of the material fact or relevant fact will lead to invalidation of the contract. That is, contract will become void if you are concealing the important facts. Coming to insurable interest or principle of insurable interest. Insured must have insurable interest in the subject matter of insurance. Insurable interest should be there. That means financial interest in the subject matter of the insurance should be there. Usually, husbands will have interest or insurable interest in the life of wife, or wife will have insurable interest in the life of husband. Partners of a business organization will have insurable interest. So, by insurable interest we means certain interest is there in the subject matter of the insurance, or financial interest is there in the subject matter of the insurance. Coming to another principle, principle of indemnity. The word indemnity means compensating somebody for the actual loss suffered by him, or restore someone to the same position that he was in before the insured event took place. With the help of principle of indemnity, we have to compensate, that is, insurance company will compensate only for the actual losses occurred. Why the insurance company is compensating? To restore that particular person to the original position before that loss has occurred. Principle of indemnity is applicable to fire insurance, marine insurance and general insurance. It is not applicable to life insurance. Why I am saying that? Can you assess the real value or worth of the life of a person? Can you give any value to the life of a person? Can you say that his life is worth rupees 5 lakh, 10 lakh, 20 lakh, 1 crore like that? No, it is not possible to value the life of any person. So, principle of indemnity means giving or covering the loss that has actually occurred. So, as we cannot assess the value of a life of a person, principle of indemnity is not applicable to life insurance. Coming to principle of contribution. If the same subject matter is insured with more than one insurer, in such case, the insurance claim to be paid to the insured must be shared by all the insurers in proportion to the sum that is assured by each of them. If one insurer has paid the full compensation to the insured, he has the right to ask another insurer to share the loss proportionately. Principle of subrogation. As per this principle, once the claim of the insured has been settled, the ownership right of the subject matter of insurance passes on to the insurer. That is, the insurance company has the full right relating to the subject matter of the insurance after settling the claim to the insured. When goods worth rupees 1 lakh are damaged due to accident and the insurance company pays the full compensation to the insured, the insurance company then can take the possession of the damaged property and is entitled to dispose that property. The remaining any amount that is coming from that damaged property will go to the insurance company only. That is principle of subrogation. Principle of mitigation. In case of a mishappening, the insured must take all possible steps to reduce the loss, to minimize the loss, or to mitigate the loss to the subject matter of the insurance. All steps should be taken by the person who has taken insurance to reduce the loss that will occur to the subject matter of insurance. The principle of mitigation ensures that the insured does not become negligent about the safety of the subject matter after taking an insurance policy. Steps should be taken to save the assets. Then only compensation will be received from the insurance company. So, minimizing the loss is the duty of the person who has taken the insurance or the insured. Principle of causa proxima. According to this principle, the insured can claim compensation only if the loss is caused by the event insured against. If a ship is insured and there is delay in unloading, and because of that, the oranges were spoiled. The oranges kept inside the ship got damaged because of the delay in unloading. Actually, we have taken the insurance for ship only. And nearest cause when we are assessing, it is the delay in unloading. So, for the oranges, even if the ship is insured, no claim will be received because ship is not at all damaged. So, the nearest cause is the delay in unloading. So, principle of causa proxima says the nearest cause for that damage should be considered, or that will be considered while settling the claim to the insured. Unless the event insured is nearest cause for the loss occurred, the insured cannot claim the loss from the insurance company. So, in this lesson, we have studied Postal and Telecom Services and Insurance.